because we live in a country like America, which is obsessed with pop music, we knew we had to make a record that was very shiny and very bright. So we made a shiny record that was bright. We just took all the songs and we listened and say, that one, that one, that one. No, this one. This one's too weird. This one's too dark. This one's too boring. No one's going to listen to a 9-minute song. Push aside, push aside. So we tried to make a very bright record that would surprise people, because again, people have a mental conception of me, conception of the music. So we thought we would reverse the idea of what the Pumpkins could be to create new energy. And so it's basically just pop record. Don't you mind? I feel that when I release the record, I think this is my 9th album, as far as an original release, and not just more material from an era. And I feel like the album that I make is never the album that people ask me about. So very quickly, there's a sort of album, an idea formed, and I answer questions about the album. So I don't know how to contextualize the way I see the album, because no one ever asked me about that. No, from the very beginning, the band's image was something that people focused on, and so we altered our image to kind of mess with people's heads, and we altered the way we were on stage to mess with people's heads, and we altered our music to mess with people's heads. So from the very beginning, even before the band's first album, the band was sort of an illusion. But we were controlling the illusion. And every time people would sort of think they knew what the band's image or musical mind was, we would change and change and change, always moving forward, because we weren't possessive of it. So it's always been a strange thing, because people are far more possessive of their own image of what I do than my own possession. I guarantee you that any artist over 40 years old has some level of resentment towards playing their old music, because it's not the same sensation for them. It's not the same feeling for them. It's not to say that they mind it. They're probably very appreciative, like I am, that there's an audience there. But when it becomes like a prison, you know, it's like your own little Bastille that you're stuck inside. My inclination as an artist is to say, go fuck off. Music is a spiritual pursuit. And the idea of the spiritual nature of music is that you must always be in the moment. So the jazz of the 50s can't be the jazz of the 60s, can't be the jazz of the 70s and onward. The rock of the 50s can't be the rock of the 60s, can't be the rock of the 60s. Right? So the grunge of the 90s can't be the grunge of 2014. It can't be. It just can't be. The energy is not the same. The feeling is not the same. We're in Paris. Is this the Art Nouveau Paris? I would prefer the Art Nouveau Paris or the Deco Paris. Should I say Paris isn't good because it's not the Paris that I want? One and all.